Hey guys, this is Wayne Hatter from Your WordPress Made Simple, and I wanted to shoot this quick video to show you how to download your files from your server. So I have a client that needs to download all of her files to her computer, and she really doesn't know how. So while showing her this video, you guys will know how to do it as well. So let's get started. Here's my hosting account. I'm at SiteGround, and I'm gonna log into my account here. So the reason that I'm logging into my account right now is because I want to create an FTP account. So I'm going to go to my accounts, and this is how I navigate to my cPanel. Then I go to cPanel. And the reason why you want to create an FTP account is because you want to be able to connect to your server to see all your files so that you can download them to your computer. So within your hosting account, your cPanel will look something like this. This is your hosting account, and you have all your controls, you have your database and all this other stuff. But what we're going to be concerned with is this section right here called files. And you'll see a little icon. It has an up arrow and a down arrow. And it's FTP accounts. So you would just go here, click on FTP accounts. And then you would create a new user to connect to your FTP account. So let's say I want this to be called downloads. Okay. Now, notice something. Be careful when you do this, because once you create the username, it's going to automatically create a directory for you. And you don't want that, especially if you want to actually connect to all your files, right? All of your websites that you have in on your server in different directories. So, but I'll get into this later on in future courses that I have on my membership site. But for now, for the sake of demo, we're just going to take out that downloads because we want to connect to the actual server. We want to see all the files. We want to see all of our websites that we have available to us. So you have your login name here. This is your username. And then you want to choose a password. So I'm just going to use the password generator. And I'll just copy that. And then you want to click here. I have copied this password. Now you can create your own password. I'm just doing this for the sake of demo. And then I'll click on use password. Okay, so everything looks good. We've got a very strong password there. And then you just click on create FTP account. And like I say, most cPanels, they look the same, just like the one that I'm using. And then usually you'll get a message that says account created. And then down here is going to start loading all of your FTP accounts. So as you can see right here, here's the new user that we created. And we're good to go. So now let's connect to our FTP or our server. And we're going to do that using a program called FileZilla. So here we go. I have FileZilla open. And if you're using FileZilla, really easy. Go to Site Manager there. And then you create a new website. We'll just say test. So now that we have our test account for our FileZilla created, I'm just going to put in my password now, since that's what I copied already. So from here on the logon type, depending on how you're connecting to your server. If you choose normal, that's the most common choice to use right there. And then I'll just paste in my password, so that's good to go. And then I'm just gonna go back to my hosting account, and then I'm gonna copy this name, and I'm gonna paste that username in right there, just like that. And now we need to put in the host name, okay? And to find that, go back to our hosting, and then we want to go back to the actual cPanel home. Yours might look different. Yours just might have a link that says home. And then once you're on your home screen of your cPanel, you just scroll down. And what I like to use to connect is the actual IP address, because I know that I'll always be connected to it. So I'll just copy that. Now you can connect to your FTP as well just by using your main domain, your primary domain name, and connect that way. But we're just going to use IP because it'll always connect with the IP. And then I'll just paste that in right there and then click connect. And then you'll see up here, it'll start connecting. And then here is your server files all over here. So if you just have one website inside your hosting account, then you probably won't have all these folders. But let's say if I just had one WordPress website installed, then I would just choose everything from WP Admin all the way down. I got some other stuff in here, but pretty much all the way down to the xmlpc.php. And then you just simply right click and then download. I'm not going to download because I don't have a folder set up for it. But I just wanted to shoot this quick video to show people how to do it in case you're wondering the same thing. And that's it. That's all I got. This is Wayne Hatter. Thank you for watching this video. And if you're looking for more step-by-step training videos, then check me out and I'll lead you to the place where you can sign up and get connected. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.